From the Home Slice News Center, this is the Daily Slice for Tuesday, September 6, 2022. I'm D-Ray Knight. This is what's going on. The Rapid City Fire Department responded to a propane tank blowing up in a backyard of a home on the west side of Rapid City on Sunday. Around 5 p.m. on Sunday, firefighters arrived at the 3200 block of Broadmoor Circle. They discovered a barbecue grill had caught fire, spreading to a covered porch and attic towards the back of the structure. Once the fire was extinguished, crews remained on scene to make sure the fire in the attic was completely out, as some spots were still smoldering. No injuries were reported. Another fire last Friday sent crews from Rapid Valley into action. Amy Rose has the details.
On Friday, the Box Elder Volunteer Fire Department responded to a fire in an occupied residential structure in the 2200 block of Sky Street. First arriving firefighters found a free-burning fire with heavy smoke conditions originating from a single-story residential structure. The firefighters were able to contain the fire to the structure of origin, stopping the spread of the flames to nearby structures and holding the call to a single alarm. Two occupants inside the structure were able to escape and were being aided by the American Red Cross.
Thick smoke from wildfires located in Idaho have blanketed the region. The smoky conditions can be detrimental to those with sensitive lungs, and those people are encouraged to limit their outdoor activity. Along with the smoke are very hot temperatures, also making it dangerous to be outside. Monday through Wednesday will feature dry weather and temperatures in the 90s to lower 100s. Relief will come late Thursday as a strong cold front pushes through the region, bringing showers late Thursday into Friday. Temperatures will be much more autumn-like at the end of the week, with highs in the 60s. In national and international news, here's the latest on the war in Ukraine. Fears are growing for Europe's largest nuclear power plant as shelling around it continues. That comes a day after the facility was again knocked off Ukraine's power grid and put in the precarious position of relying on its own power to run safety systems. Repeated warnings from world leaders that fighting around the Zaporizhzhia plant has put it in an untenable situation that could lead to a nuclear catastrophe have done little to stem the hostilities. Russian-installed officials accused Ukrainian forces of shelling the city where the plant is located on Tuesday. Hours earlier, the Ukrainians said Kremlin forces attacked a city across the river. A judge has granted former President Donald Trump's request for a special master in the Mar-a-Lago document search. Amy Rose has more.
A federal judge has granted a request by former President Donald Trump's legal team to appoint a special master to review documents seized by the FBI during a search of his Florida home last month. The decision by U.S. District Judge Eileen Cannon came despite the objections of the Justice Department, which said an outside legal expert was not necessary in part because officials had already completed their review of potentially privileged documents. The appointment may slow the pace of the department's investigation into the presence of top-secret information at Mar-a-Lago, but it is not clear whether it will affect any investigative decisions or the ultimate outcome of the probe.
Canadian police are hunting for the remaining suspect in the stabbing deaths of 10 people in an Indigenous community and nearby town in Saskatchewan after finding the body of his brother amid a massive manhunt for the pair. Damian Sanderson, 31, was found dead Monday near the stabbing sites, and authorities believe his brother and fellow suspect Miles Sanderson, age 30, is injured, on the run, and likely in the provincial capital of Regina. RCMP Commanding Officer Assistant Commissioner Rhonda Blackmore said authorities are not sure of the cause of death yet, but the injuries were not self-inflicted. Your weather forecast from the Home Slice Weather Center. Sunny with record high temperatures and a high of 97. Low tonight, 68. And that was your Daily Slice for Tuesday, September 6th, 2022. The Daily Slice is a production of Home Slice Media Group, hosted by D-Ray Knight with Amy Rose. Executive producer Mark Houston, engineered by Chris Jacquez. I'm D-Ray Knight. Have a great day.